Peanut butter incense.
Good evening from West Allis Athletic Fields. It is the spring alternate football season. And tonight we have the Racine Horlick Rebels and the West Allis Central Bulldogs. The Rebels come in 1-0 on the year after a big win over Park last week, 16-6 in that one. And then for West Allis Central, they fell to Brown Deer 30-9 last week. I'm Don Wadowitz, joined by Cody Ortner. We're happy to be bringing you this broadcast of Horlick Rebels football, and glad to be bringing it from sunny skies, although 34 degrees, and due to some COVID things, Cody, they have us up on the roof, which is fine. We're very appreciative of the West Allis School District just allowing us to be here, to be able to test out this streaming equipment, and to be able to provide this broadcast back to the folks in Racine.
Absolutely. Great to be here. Glad to be here. Very appreciative, like you said, but it feels like a day. It'd be about mid-October, late October, the weather feels like right now, not a cloud in the sky. It is beautiful, but you know what? We got some baseball earlier today, and now we're getting high school football right now. Who would have thought?
Opening day and then the second week of high school football season. Just it seems surreal. You know, it seems like April 1st. Like somebody's just messing with us.
Exactly.
You know, it was nice. Normally, opening day, it's you get this chilly weather, but I know opening days, I've been out there, and it has been where you have the freezing rain coming down as you're trying to tailgate. And of course, the Brewers provide fans with one of the best games in probably a decade on opening day, and pull out that big victory today in extra innings. And turning to this game, the West Allis Central Bulldogs under first-year head coach Steve Stoom, they lost to Brown Deer big last week, 30-9. It was 8-5 Brown Deer at the half. And then they allowed 16 third-quarter points, and three of those were Pat TDs. They actually did all right when you think about the running game. And that right now, it looks like is going to be the strength of Horlick this season.
Yeah, for West Allis Central, like you said, they were only down 8-0 last week at halftime to Brown Deer. And it looks like just a lot of halftime adjustments made by Brown Deer. Were they able to get some things going in the passing game, especially in the third quarter, able to get ahead. And it led to a lot of just instances where West Allis is just trying to play catch up, trying to work things through in the passing game. Just 4 of 18 last week through the air for the senior quarterback, Joey Tanzillo, and it was just rough going for this West Allis Central offense.
And meanwhile, Horlick, they had some turnovers, but they rushed for almost 300 yards, 6.3 yards per carry. Their defense limited Park to just 75 yards of offense, including 25 yards on 18 rushing attempts. But a big win over their crosstown rival, a game that had to be moved down to Kenosha. Played at Bradford because of some field condition issues at the brand new Pritchard Park turf field.
Yeah, some different instances for Horlick last week. And coming into the season, too, you know, they lost their leading receiver from 2019. But they had some balance going. The passing game going well for the sophomore quarterback, Blake Felcher, 5-10 last week, 46 yards. Did throw an interception, but also got 44 yards on the ground on 11 carries. So they have some mobility at the quarterback position, but they're able to get some good rushing yards as well, too, from their sophomore running back, Reggie Hubbard, as well. 7 carries, 70 yards.
Yeah, and you look at Fletcher really hit the weight room hard in the offseason, the son of head coach Brian Fletcher. So a little bit maybe more pressure when you're the coach's kid and you're being put under center there. But this is a team, when you look at their sophomores, the sophomores have played together since eighth grade in the startup youth program for Horlick. Fletcher, Cozy, Dabrowski, Suarez, they're the kind of that first class to really go through that youth program. So they have experience with one another. They've been running this offense for a couple of years now. And so even without having to have as many practices as you would if you had the normal season, getting things started later and such, they were able to understand what's going on, and you didn't have to bring them up to speed on that part of it.
Absolutely, and half the thing, the biggest thing in team sports especially, is building that chemistry and them guys having that time together in past years and to be able to carry it now to varsity level is special for them, and hopefully they just continue to grow and grow.
And you talked about Elias Williams last year, not only their leading rusher, but their leading receiver as well. He had 683 yards on the ground, 171 yards through the air. And now the national anthem here at West Allis Athletic Field.
And all those who serve to protect it with the playing of our national anthem.
Top of the roof here at West Allis Central, down in the press box, a little bit tight down there already, so they asked if we wouldn't mind moving to the rooftop, and we said sure, and I guess my mind was thinking it was this weekend already when it's supposed to be in the 60s, and I was like, oh, this isn't going to be a big deal, and here we are. You know, face masks will help keep our mouths and our nose warm and all that kind of fun stuff. We are a two-man crew due to the COVID restrictions, so just so you know, Cody will be on the camera along with commentary. I'm going to be doing some of the production efforts here on the broadcast along with giving you the play-by-play. We're going to try and keep up with stats and all those other good things, but just ask for your patience a little bit here tonight as this is a test of the system and just to see what we can do with this streaming system that we will be using for the Racine Raiders season, which will be starting up at the end of May. So make sure you look out for that too. Happy to be bringing you this game of Horlick Rebels football against the West Allis Central Bulldogs, courtesy of the Racine Raiders organization. So thank you for tuning in tonight. We appreciate everybody that is on board on the YouTube channel with us. A couple dozen of you out there enjoying our broadcast here tonight. Just so you know, because of copyright issues with music in the background, and we are sandwiched between three speakers here, we will be going silent during breaks after scores at the quarters, at the half. You won't hear sound at those points in time because we don't want to get flagged by YouTube for having copyrighted material. So it's going to be West Allis Central football to begin in their black and athletic gold jerseys with athletic gold numbers and getting things ready for the Rebels. And actually, right off the bat, don't think we have a number on a player here. So getting ready to kick off. It'll be Keyless back deep for West Allis Central, standing back at the 12. This short week also is very difficult. We reached out to the head coaches, but they weren't able to get back to us with this short week. And here we go, the right to left pooch kick. It's going to go outside the numbers, and West Allis Central not able to get there. The up man just let Adrian it go right Richmond by, and Adrian Richmond comes up with the football for Horlick. So West Allis Central thinking that they're going to get the football and have a chance against this Horlick defense that did so well last week, and instead it will be Horlick out there leading things off, and they will have very good starting field position. The JV game, what was it, 58-6 in favor of Horlick, I believe.
Yeah, something like that. Tough way to start for Central. Let's see what the Horlick offense could do to start things off.
Horlick with their white jerseys with scarlet highlights as they send out two receivers to the right, one receiver to the left, and now a player running onto the field a little bit late for Horlick is Logan Ray. And instead, they send out Monte Spragans. It's going to be an empty back set for Fletcher. Fletcher is going to twist and run off of left tackle, finds a lane. Fletcher down inside the 25 to the 23-yard line, and Fletcher right away, pickup of 11 on the first play, and it'll be a first down for Horlick.
A hurry-up offense here for the Horlick offense.
Setting up a good pace for Horlick. Coming in off the left side is Jordan Brown. He would go into the backfield to the right of Fletcher. Two receivers offset to the right for Horlick as they look to the wheel on the sideline. It looks like an old poker table that they ripped apart and they put their plays on there. Fletcher in the pistol, takes the snap, fakes the handoff, rolls out to his right, looking to pass, and he's able to hit his tight end, Tommy Triggs. Triggs down the far sideline will be brought down at the 5-yard line. It's going to be a pickup of 18. Right off the bat on that one, and another first down for Horlick, one on the ground, one through the air. And Triggs last week had two catches for 17 yards and a two-point conversion catch. Horlick knocking on the doorstep right off the bat here after recovering the onside kick. And
looks like some confusion coming in from the sideline.
First and goal for the Rebels from the six.
And now they're set. Fletcher takes, and he's going to run right up the gut, and he holds his footing and dives into the end zone.
Touchdown,
Horlick.
Rebels.
Fletcher, his first rushing TD of the season, comes from 4 yards out, and Horlick on the board right away, just a minute four into the game, and Fletcher gets the 4-yard TD run.
Great effort by Fletcher. Great effort also at the offensive line to be able to create a space for him to run through. And it was just him once he got to the second level. Fletcher was able to just kind of get across the end zone.
Following the 6-yard touchdown run, Similek on to try the point after.
So Similek will go with what Dan Pfeiffer, the public address announcer, says for the point after. Horlick went for it every time. It's a swinging gate formation. And now they're going to go into a more regular extra point attempt here as Aiden Graham will put it down for Similek. Horlick went for two all last week. Similek's kick is low and it's wide to the left. And Horlick leads 6-0 with 10:56 to play in our opening quarter. We'll be back in just a moment here on the Racine Raiders broadcast of Horlick Rebels football. So Horlick moves it right away into the end zone, and they take a 6-0 lead on West Allis Central. And Horlick, they started off last week's game with that little squib kick against Park, and they didn't get it to work, but here on this first attempt, they were able to recover that onside kick as the up man for West Allis Central just let the ball go by, and it just kind of was set up perfectly right between him and the next person back. So here's Similek again with Horlick leading 6-0 with 10:56 on the clock. He'll pooch it the other way, and this time West Allis Central will let it go off bounds. It just goes out. Right on top of it was Nico Safidis, and it'll be a penalty against Horlick, and it'll be good starting field position for West Allis Central with 10:54 to go. In our opening quarter, Horlick scoring on their opening drive and leading 6-0.
Well, hopefully Central now can capitalize on the penalty with good field position and help their offense out a little bit too.
So West Allis Central will have it at their own 35-yard line. As their senior quarterback will bring them out in Joey Tanzillo. And Tanzillo as we talked about in the pregame, just 4 of 18 for 52 yards passing.
First and 10 last for the Dogs from the 35.
Tanzillo under center. He'll have wings on each side and a back behind him. Tanzillo ducks under center. Long snap count from Tanzillo. He takes and he hands it off. Right up the middle goes Safidis, and Safidis fought back by that stout Horlick defense.
With the carry.
He'll pick up a yard, and that is it. And it'll bring up second down and 9.
Great job by the interior defensive line for Horlick. And then the linebackers crashing in as well, making sure he doesn't get through. And a great stop there on
game
first down.
The
tempo
down
is set
control
for this Horlick team. They already got the touchdown offensively, and now to see what the defense can do.
Yeah, that's a bonus possession right off the bat for
second
Horlick.
Down.
The opening
the
kickoff
down,
being able to recover that. Two wings off on each side for Central. They'll have Safidis behind Tanzillo. Horlick with 9 in the box against this bunch formation. Tanzillo takes, fakes the handoff, rolling out to his left. Under pressure, tosses it up, and nobody there. The closest player was Aiden Graham for the Rebels up around the 45-yard line. It'll bring up a third down and 9 for Central.
A lot of times you see in these early season games is a lot of penalties, especially false starts. The offenses are trying to get in sync, and it looks like there the passing game is just, they're still working out the kinks in the offense.
Jordan Brown was applying the pressure coming off the right side of the defensive line for Horlick. 9:57 to play in our opening quarter. 6-0, the Horlick lead here at the West Allis Athletic Complex. A receiver split out wide to the left. That'll be JoJo Keyless. Receiver right off the line on the left side. One right off the line on the right. I formation backfield behind Tanzillo. Safidis the fullback. Fakes the handoff to Safidis under immediate pressure. Throws it up and it'll be
Tanzillo's
incomplete. Looking for Quillis at the 43-yard line on the far side of the field. And it's going to bring up a fourth down for Central, and they'll be forced to likely punt here with 9:51 to play. Short possession as it takes up just a minute off the clock.
Yeah, good pressure there by the Horlick defense. And yeah, good field position after the penalty on the kickoff. Central just not able to turn anything out with just a yard.
Tanzillo back to punt, so you do have the quarterback punting, so something got to be aware of here for Horlick. And he's not fully back in a full punt distance. He's only a shotgun back. He takes, gets off a little pooch kick off the side of his foot. It's going to land at the 42 and take a Horlick bounce and be downed at the 42-yard line. That punt will go for just 6 yards.
And
Horlick, again, will have excellent starting field position as they start their second drive of the game with 9:46 on the clock.
Rough start for the Bulldogs, and having the turnover to start, and then they only have a 5-yard punt, set up great field position for the Raiders.
For the Rebels.
Rebels, excuse me.
All good. Spragans will be
for the Rebels
back
from the 41.
Behind Fletcher. Two receivers off to the right, one receiver off the line on the left side as Fletcher will go under center. And he hands it off, and breaking through the line is Spragans. Spragans down the far numbers, inside the 25 to the 24-yard line.
And
Spragans with a quick gain of 17 yards and another Horlick first down.
Spragans off to the races. Central defense is having a hard time. Once it gets to that second level, the secondary just wasn't able to answer right away.
Central getting a player off the field, and Spragans with a big week last week against Park as he went for 104 yards on 15 carries. Some confusion again here by Horlick as they're trying to
first and 10 for the Rebels,
see if
the
they should be running players on or off as Logan Ray was looking to come on. And now looking over to the sideline again is Fletcher, and he's finally going to get under center. In motion is Hubbard, and the handoff goes to Spragans. Spragans all the way inside the 5 as he found a lane
Spragans
down to the 2-yard line. A pickup of 22 in Spragans with 39 yards on 2 carries. And Horlick, they have gotten a touchdown or a first down every time they've touched the ball in this game so far.
The center and the right guard doing their work so far. Plenty of room for Spragans to run.
every play they've run. And there again, Spragans into the end zone from 2 yards out. Another touchdown for Horlick as they take a 12-zip lead with 8:56 to play.
Holding against
and actually
the
take
Rebels.
That. It's going to come back as the Rebels are going to get nailed for holding. Didn't see the yellow on the field. So that'll push them back 10 yards, take the 6 off the board.
Holding is a spot foul in the high school game.
They'll have it back at the 11-yard line. So first and goal from the 11. Spragans exits, as does Brown. Letcher, working out of the pistol formation, has Cozy next to him. Fletcher sends Cozy out to the left. Takes the snap, looking to pass, looking to go for Cozy, and it's nearly picked off. And is it diving in behind the play is Bryce Whiting, and Whiting
Fletcher
is going to pick off the Fletcher
by
pass.
Bryce Whiting!
And Fletcher just kind of threw that one up there as a jump ball to see if his receiver could go and get it and end up getting tipped up in the air. Looked like it was going to get intercepted initially by the Bulldogs, and then on a second effort, able to get the interception for Central.
So Central with West Allis knocker with Horlick knocking on the door, able to come up with a turnover, and that was one big Achilles heel for Horlick last week, Cody, was they turned the ball over 4 times in that game.
And that turnover wouldn't have happened just now if it wasn't for the holding call on the play before. That was a touchdown. They were set to go up 12-0.
Yeah, and Spragans made it in pretty easily on that play, and So Tanzillo with his team back at their own 20-yard line following the touchback on the interception. So Fetus behind him, and that's where the handoff goes. The ball is on the ground, and it's recovered by Horlick right away. Picking it up is Jordan Brown. On the fumble by Stavitis.
On the carry, fumble.
Well, speaking of the turnovers by Horlick, a problem last week, it's already a problem this week for Central.
Number 4, Jordan
Brown. All I'm doing is flipping my stat sheet over from one side to the next right now. Back-to-back turnovers. Brown with the fumble recovery for Horlick there to get the ball back, and they have excellent starting field position again at the Central 19-yard line.
8:44 left in the first, already 3 turnovers in this game.
Spragans in the down forms position takes the handoff, and Spragans, nobody around him, and he's gonna walk in.
Monte
touchdown
with the
Rebels.
Carry, 19
Spragans,
yards, touchdown,
who looked to have a touchdown on the last drive, gets one on this one with a 19-yard TD run, a drive that ends up lasting just 5 seconds after the fumble recovery, and it looks this time like Horlick is going to go for 2.
Following the touchdown run, the Rebels will go
for
2.
Their extra point being wide to the left last time. Spragans is the one back in the backfield. If Fletcher looking to pass, now he may run. Now he fires one, and it's too hot for his intended receiver.
Look
that he was looking for. Tommy Triggs on that one. But Horlick takes a 12-zip lead with 8:39 to play here. In the first quarter,
West Allis Central
we'll be back in a moment on the Racine Raiders YouTube
stream. The West Allis Athletic Complex, where tonight.
Similek tees it up for the Rebels, who find themselves up 12-zip just 3.5 minutes into the game. A 4-yard TD run by Fletcher, 19-yard run by Spragans. This one a deeper line drive kick, and it's going to be picked up back at the 14-yard line by Safidis, and Safidis will be pounded backwards at the 19-yard line, and West Allis Central will be starting deep in their own territory again with 8:34 on the clock here in the first quarter, trailing by a dozen.
Well, time to see what this Central offense is made of now, backed up closer to their 20-yard line. They had good field position to start out their last drive, but things just only, there's a three and out, only a gain of a yard on that drive, so we'll see what they can do down 12-0 here early on in the first.
And Safidis will exit after returning that kick, and Horlick trying a few different things on the kickoff here
first
today. A couple
of
squibs and then that line drive kick. Have some extra beef in the backfield for the Rebels. Looks to be Joe Lynch, an offensive lineman, defensive lineman in the backfield, or for Central, I should say, the Bulldogs. Two wings on each side. And the handoff goes to Angelo Rivera
with the carry.
And Rivera is going to be taken down for a two-yard loss.
With the tackle.
Great penetration there by the defensive lineman there for Horlick. They're able to get through right away, and there's no chance of getting any yardage on that play.
Yeah, that Horlick defense is looking really, really good. And the offense here, the rushing offense, is already taking off for Horlick. That is
second
a strength right now
Dogs
of this team. Jaden Williams was the one with the tackle for loss there for Horlick. And again, in the backfield for Central will be Angelo Rivera, listed as an offensive lineman slash defensive lineman. Anzillo under center, takes the snap. He's looking to pass, rolling out to his right, under pressure now, and he's going to step out of bounds down the near sideline at the 20-yard line, so it'll be a gain of just one for Anzillo. Or check that with the loss of yardage, a 2-yard gain for Anzillo, and they'll bring up a third down and nine.
Good effort by Anzillo, just trying to make something out of nothing. He was looking downfield to find a receiver. Great coverage in the secondary for Horlick, and Anzillo just had to go out of bounds and settle for a couple of yards.
7.5 minutes to play here in the first quarter. 12-0 the Horlick lead.
Third and nine.
They recovered
the
opening kick, an onside kick, and went into the end zone. Then after fumbling, they are throwing an interception. They ended up recovering a fumble and getting it back in on the very next play. Safidis in the backfield this time, and might be a false start. Safidis moved, or actually Rivera that back there. But this might go against Horlick. Horlick was flinching on the line as well. But Rivera had started moving forward, took a step forward. They didn't see that, and Horlick will get the five.
Neutral zone, yeah,
the middle linebacker, Fletcher.
Horlick.
He was trying to get his defensive lineman to try and get them to flinch. And just a little bit too much there.
It was definitely a longer snap count by Anzillo, but they'll bring up a third down and five. Or third and four for Central. Two wings on each side. Rivera the back in the backfield behind Anzillo, who's under center. Horlick with five on the line here. Anzillo takes, fakes the handoff, and ends up giving it to the back coming from the left side. That's Austin Fenske, and Fenske losing a couple of yards on the play. It's going to be a loss of three, and it'll bring up a fourth down and seven for West Allis Central.
You've noticed so far early on, you've seen the interior defensive linemen for Horlick having their way with the offensive line from Central, with the linebackers creating a lot of speed as well, too, able to get in the backfield and make some good open field tackles.
Anzillo on and punt.
Anzillo will look to punt here. And again, the last time when he tried to punt, he was not even as far back as you might be for a shotgun. It was almost more a pistol, as he is again here, and he got one off the tip of the toe. He's going to throw, and he's going to go for the home run, and making the catch down the far sideline for Central is JoJo Keyless across midfield. They'll say right to midfield, a 28-yard pickup for Central.
Central finally able to get a break, and they got man-to-man coverage on the outside, thinking that it was going to be a punting situation, and they just heaved it downfield, and a great effort and a great catch made.
It'll be their football at midfield, the first down of the game for Central. Two receivers off to the right side for
following
the Bulldogs.
28-yard completion, first and 10 for the Dogs.
Working out of the pistol is Anzillo. Anzillo takes, looking to pass, throwing over to Keyless, and Keyless It's a little bit too high. Can't come up with
Tanzillo's
it. And it's incomplete. It'll bring up
Mikulis.
A second down and 10. And Tanzillo, 1 of 4 for 28 yards in this game. And we talked about it last week. Just 22% of his passes completed. And
Mikulis is
slow to get up. And he's one of the nicer pieces for this team early on, as Mikulis last week did have a couple of catches for 12 yards, 5 rushes, only went for 4 yards, but a decent part of this offense for Central.
Yeah, you hope he's all right. It looks like he's got up on his own power, and the athletic trainer coming out to attend to him, so hopefully he's okay. But yeah, a big part of this offense, and hopefully they're able to have somebody come in and be able to produce as well, whether it be underclassmen, upperclassmen, doesn't matter.
Yeah, both these teams young, 7 seniors on both squads, and you know, both teams, because of this season, you have players that may be playing other sports that had to make a choice, football or some other sport, you know, with all the extra sports that have been piled on here in the spring, and so I know for sure numbers are down at Horlick. I imagine that's probably the same for West Allis Central as well. 2nd and 10 from midfield for the Bulldogs. Rivera and Tanzillo having a conversation before Tanzillo gets under center. Tanzillo takes, fakes the handoff twice, under pressure, throwing. The pass is complete to Safidis, and Safidis gets hit hard and coughs it off
Tanzillo's
at midfield.
Pass is complete to Nico Safidis.
And we'll have to wait to see who came up with it here. And they're going to say that Central was able to recover.
Safidis recovers his own fumble
on that play, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 10, no gain.
Well, thanks for a lucky bounce for Safidis there. He fumbled the football after making the completion, but then a defender for Racine Horlick was trying to get it, bounced right back to Safidis, and he was able to fall on top of it. So the drive continues, but it's been close to being another turnover.
5.5 minutes to play in our opening quarter. 12-0 the Horlick lead here at West Allis Athletic Complex. Rivera, the back behind Tanzillo as he ducks under center. Double wings on each side for Tanzillo. Tanzillo hands it off to Rivera. Rivera slips by the first tackler but cannot get away from Anon Houston. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up another 4th down for Central. And you'd imagine after the converting on the last one that they're going to try and do it again here in their best opportunity early on in this game.
Good job by Houston there, reading that play all the way and making a great tackle. But yeah, you know, they surprised us the last 4th down with heaving it down the field and getting a big 1st down, making their first 1st down of the game. Let's see what they try and do here.
They're going to send a couple of receivers out wide to the left. Safidis out way wide, and Fenske in the slot on the left side. Rivera is going to be in front of Tanzillo, as this may be a punt. And Tanzillo gets this one high up in the air. It's going to hit at the 20, and it will pretty much die there. Fenske goes as he knocks it at the 21-yard line and knocks it backwards. But good sell on that one, but not going to get you any extra yards there.
Well, you knew that Horlick was going to be prepared if they were going to try and pass it downfield that time, and at least that time they were able to get a good punt off. The last one only just 5 yards. This one they were able to pin it back towards the 20-yard line.
And Horlick, for the first time, starting on their side of the field with the ball at the 21-yard line with 4:09 to play in the opening quarter. Horlick with a 12-0 lead as we're standing on the roof of the West Press Box here at West Allis Athletic Fields. Fletcher will go under center with Spragans behind him. Fletcher gives to Spragans, and a big hole again. Spragans, middle of the field, the 40. Spragans, the 45, up to the 47-yard line before Whitey takes him down. They'll mark him at the 48, officially a 27-yard pickup for Spragans, and he's had runs of 17, 22, 19, and 27 as he's already up near 100 yards.
Yeah, a great game by him too, but you got to give the credit to the offensive line. They are creating a lot of space for him to run through.
Yeah, Spragans is not being touched for the first 10, 15 yards right now. Same formation for Horlick. And this time the handoff goes to Sean Griffin, and Griffin cuts it outside the hash marks down to the 32-yard line. And he'll pick up another first down.
Sean Griffin with the carry.
And it looks like a lot of time, too, for Central, the defense is just confused by who's getting the football. They got a lot of guys going in motion, and you're not really sure at first who's going to get it. And so far, Horlick is taking full advantage of that so far.
From the Central 32.
20-yard gain for Griffin on that one. And now we have a whistle, and we are going to have a timeout taken by Central. They trail 12-0 with 3:17 to play in the first quarter. We'll step away for just a moment, and we'll come back. Horlick will have it first and 10 at the West Allis Central 32-yard line. First and 10 for Horlick at the 32-yard line of West Allis Central. Again, we will go audio off. We'll mute our audio when we put up any of the normal placards during timeouts and those sorts of things to avoid YouTube taking us off the air. We don't want that to happen for any of us, so that's when you won't hear audio. Coming around and taking the handoff and heading down the near sideline for the Rebels is Brown, and Brown down inside the five, and they will say he stepped out of bounds at the 4-yard line, a pickup of 28 for Brown, and Horlick is just getting huge, huge chunks of yardage, but it's coming back for another hold against Horlick.
Illegal procedure.
So take that one off the board by Brown, a nice run.
Yeah, they are having their way, and the only thing that's been holding them back is penalties so far, regardless being up 12-0, but they have had one touchdown come back due to a penalty, and then they turned the ball over the very next play.
Three penalties for 25 yards for the Rebels in the game, and they've also thrown an interception. Those were big Achilles heels last week, but you're going to see those probably quite a bit in this abbreviated spring season. Practices were abbreviated, everything abbreviated, so coaches nowhere near where they would like to be in many cases with their teams. It'll bring up a first down and 15 for Horlick.
First and 15
as they check the wheel, and now getting under center is Fletcher. Fletcher takes, gives to Brown again, coming around, and Brown again with the lane. Brown the 20, Brown the 15, the 10, the 5, before he is taken down, and bringing him down is Saul Martinez, a pickup of 32, and right away, Brown able to get that yardage back, and then some, basically, or about the same as what he was. He was down inside the 4.
Yeah, it looks like they basically just ran the same exact play they did prior on the play that ended up being a penalty that set them back, but Brown just get to the outside, and his speed was so much incredible once he got to the second level, and just not able to bring him down until inside the 10-yard line.
Cozy first will be out wide to the right, and check that. That's actually Steinmetz with the numbers on the Horlick jerseys. A little hard to see some of those sometimes. A keeper by Fletcher, and he heaves the ball over the goal line. He's in for his second touchdown of the game. The first a 5-yard run. This one a 4-yard run. This one a 5-yard run. And with 2:07 to play in the first quarter, Horlick up 18-0. On West Allis Central.
Great jump by the offensive line, and Fletcher was able to just go towards the end zone almost effortlessly. He had a Nice wall right in front of him.
Following
able to get in. And then a big touchdown for Horlick.
On to try the point after for Horlick.
So Horlick will try the extra point. They tried the extra point after their first touchdown. It was wide to the left. Then they went for the two-point conversion, failed on the pass, and now they're in the swinging gate, and they're going to throw it out of the swinging gate, and they throw it to Brown, who takes it into the end zone for the two-point conversion.
Jordan Brown, the two-point conversion is good.
Well, I've never actually seen a team run a play out of the swinging gate live. That was pretty cool to see, and it gives Horlick a 20-0 lead over West Allis Central with 2:07 to play in the first quarter. We'll be back in just a moment as we silence the audio and leave you with a little advertisement from the Raiders. Similic on to kick off for Horlick. It's a 20-0 Rebels lead. The JV team won 58-6 in the early game. This a high kick that's going to be taken at the 22-yard line by Safidis, and Safidis up to the 35. It'll equal the best starting field position for West Allis Central in the game. Since the second, or their first possession, actually, the second Horlick kickoff of the game that went out of bounds, which started Central at their 35.
And we were talking in the pregame about how these sophomores for Horlick have been together for quite a while, coming through that youth program, and that chemistry is showing so far.
Yeah, they've had that opportunity to get to know one another. So, the coaches, even when the coaches aren't around, they've been able to, they know the language. They understand what they're doing. And that really helps. That puts you far ahead of some teams that may not have something as well established. Receiver off to the left. I formation backfield behind Tanzillo. Tanzillo takes, gives to Safidis, the first back through, and Safidis will try and power his way ahead for a couple of yards, but not much doing. They'll actually give him credit for just a yard. Brings up a second down and nine, and we are seeing that Horlick defense again here, Cody. They are just not allowing anything for West Allis Central on the ground.
Yeah, they're kind of settling in on the ground game and trying to see and make them throw the football. We've seen it a couple of times where they try to work it downfield. It worked on a fourth down where they thought they were going to punt. They were pinned back right around their 20-25. Got it downfield. It worked that time, but they just really haven't had too much balance so far.
Good to see that JoJo Keyless is in the game. He's split out out to the left after having an injury. Backfield for Central is Safidis along with Fenske. And the handoff goes to Fenske, and he tries to break it outside, and he's contacted right at the line of scrimmage, and then Fletcher comes in to clean
Austin
it up.
Fenske,
no gain again, and it brings up, a loss of one will bring up a third down and
loss
10.
Loss of one on the play. Third down,
yeah,
Central.
For Horlick, they're just leaving their corners out on an island with the receivers and letting everybody else just crash in on the run game.
45 seconds left to play in our opening quarter. It's been all Horlick. 20-0 here at the West Allis Athletic Complex in the suburb of Milwaukee. Keyless breaks out wide to the left. Tight ends on each side. I formation backfield behind Tanzillo. Fenske the deep back, Safidis the fullback. Takes, gives to Fenske, and Fletcher cuts through the line and takes down Fenske for a loss of five all the way back to the 30-yard line. And West Allis Central can only go backwards on this drive. And that will be the final play of our first quarter. They'll flip sides, and West Allis Central will be looking in low likelihood to punt, although they've already faked one here today successfully. We'll be back in just a moment. You're watching Horlick Rebels football, brought to you courtesy of the Racine Raiders. Thank you.
begin the second quarter, fourth and 15 for the Dogs
Central as they start, or as they're at their own 30. This drive has gone backwards 5 yards.
Tanzillo,
and again,
Tanzillo
only stands back at about shotgun depth. And they've already faked one successfully. He was able to hit Keyless on a big play, their only first down of the game. They have Keyless out wide to the right. Fenske in the slot to the right. Third player just off the line as well for Central, as that is Aponte Jr. looking to pass under heavy pressure, rolling out, and he's just going to go out of bounds. Tanzillo will lose a bunch of yardage all the way back to the 9-yard line, and a Horlick player is in some pain on the sideline. It looks to be Lamonte Henderson that is maybe cramping up down there. But it ends up being a loss of 9 on the run by Tanzillo. And at that point, he's not in any position to really be able to throw it up. But you got to get it downfield somewhere.
Yeah, somehow, some way, just not able to do that. And a great job by the pass rush to make him go to the opposite way he wants to throw.
So Horlick set up at the West Allis 21-yard line. Not their best starting field position of the day. Spragans takes a handoff and a big lane again for Spragans. And he's into the end zone from 21 yards out for his second touchdown of the game for Horlick. And they take a 26-zip lead with 11:48 to play here in the first half.
Spragans just showing off his speed once again, and a great job that time on the left side of the line, able to create a seam for him to run through, and he was able to get to the end zone with ease.
106 yards on 5 carries for Spragans, and he was at 104 last week, so big game already for him. And they're going to go into a kick formation here. Give Similik a chance after getting the touchdown out of the swinging gate last time.
Kind of wanted to see it again.
Hold is down. It was a little high, and the kick, is blocked. And it's blocked by Austin Fenske.
The Horlick Rebels.
Horlick leads, though, 26-0. Even with the blocked kick. With 11:48 to play in our first half. We'll step away for a moment. You're watching Horlick Rebels football, brought to you courtesy of the Racine Raiders. Similik will tee it up for Horlick, who lead 26-0 with 11:48 to play in the first half. Keyless back deep for the Bulldogs, waiting to return the kick. And it'll go off to the near side of the field and be picked up by Fenske instead. He'll try and cut all the way across, finds a little bit of a lane up across the 25-yard line at the far hash marks, and he'll bring it up to the 28-yard line. And West Allis Central will have it there with 11:40 to play in the first half. Nice little return by Fenske. When he started going laterally, I worried a little bit,
but
then he ended up being able to use one of his blockers and found a little bit of running room there.
And now for the Bulldog offense. We've seen them in the passing game, usually only on third and fourth downs. I wouldn't mind them trying to go to the air, maybe on first and second down, see if you can get something out of that to find a little bit of balance on offense.
10 carries for minus 16 yards and a fumble right now for the West Allis Central Bulldogs. The pitch goes off to the right side and nowhere to go. Tried a quick hitter. Going to be good for a gain of a yard. And with that carry was Safidis.
Nico
brings
Sefidis
up a second down and nine. As Sefidis has, other than the fumble, he's gone forward
on
his
play.
Other three
second
carries at least, and he's the only one for Central outside of a two-yard run early on by Tanzillo that's been able second to pick up positive yardage against this Horlick defense. 11 minutes to go here in the first half. 26-0, the Horlick lead. Sefidis, the lone back in the backfield. Tanzillo looking to pass. Steps up in the pocket. He's going to try and run. And coming up and saying, no way, that is not going to happen for Horlick is Adrian Richard. He'll pick up a yard up to the 30-yard line, but that is it. It looked like there is going to be some running room, and Richard just out of nowhere.
Yeah, he was able to find some space, Tanzillo was, and yeah, all of a sudden the linebacker comes up and delivered one big hit to Tanzillo. Able to get a yard, but they tried to go to the air. The pressure came right away.
A lot of activities going on. They have soccer on the other side of us here, across from us. You might see some extra lights, and they have a, looks to be turf soccer field here as well, and they have a women's or a girls' soccer game going on. Third and eight with about 10 minutes to play in the first half for West Allis Central. Sefidis is the lone back in the backfield, a pair of wings on each side for Tanzillo. Tanzillo on the keeper, slips one tackle, slips another tackle, but then Brown is able to wrap him up. Tanzillo up across the 30 to the 33-yard line as he picks up 3 yards on the carry, and it'll bring up a fourth down and six for West Allis Central, ball at their own 33-yard line.
A good effort there by Tanzillo, just trying to get some extra yardage, and he was able to break through a couple of tackles early on there and try to move it forward. Comes up short, a fourth and five, and for the Bulldog offense, they're just not able to get things going, whether it be through the ground, through the air. It's just been tough sledding so far, and a great job by the Horlick defense.
2 of 5 through the air for 30 yards. Of course, that big 28-yarder on fourth down that they're able to connect on. And they are going to line up in a normal offensive position here with Tanzillo with their wings on each side. And he has Sefidis as the back behind him. Just one first down in the game for Central. And that came on a fourth down play. Hands it off to Keyless, coming around. Keyless with some room, gets the edge. Keyless the 40, he'll have the first down. Up across the 40 to the 41-yard line. Keyless with a pickup of 8. And they move the chains for the first time on the ground in the game. Their second first down of the contest with 8:45 to play here in the first half, trailing 26-0 to Horlick.
It looked like they took that play right out of the Rebels playbook. We've been seeing that a lot already tonight for Horlick, and they're able to capitalize on that and finally get a first down on the ground.
Starting to get really chilly up here now, Cody.
I don't know.
See our breath.
From their own 42.
I can see my breath, but I think I'm starting to warm up.
Well, that's one of us. And you have a lot less weight on you. Some of my blubber should be helping me out. One back in the backfield again. That's the fetus. Tanzillo under center. Pair of wings on each side. Hands it off to Keyless. The wing coming from the left side. Couple blockers in front of them, but Horlick doing a Keyless good job of standing them up. So they were kind of being blockers more
Cozy
than anything else.
And
Cozy with the tackle. It'll be a loss of a yard back to the 41-yard line.
And once again on the onside, the linebacker's able to crash. You've seen Fletcher all over the field. He is the quarterback for this Horlick offense, but also the middle linebacker. He's able to just kind of get to both sides and create a lot of havoc for this Central offense.
He's a quarterback on both sides of the ball.
There you go.
8:10 to play in the first half. 26-0 in favor of Horlick. A second down and 11 for Central. Keyless, one of the wings on the left side. He's gotten a couple of carries here on this drive. Sefidis, the lone back behind Tanzillo on the delay counter. He hands it off to Sefidis, and Fletcher again in on the tackle for Horlick. As a pickup of a yard, they might give him 2 here. We'll bring up a third down and 9 and give him credit for 2.
1 yard gain.
Not much room there for Sefidis, as he's got 5 carries in the game for 5 yards and the fumble lost. Third and 9 for the Bulldogs. Horlick's defense getting it done. Offense getting it done too.
For the Dogs from their own 42.
They'll be working out of the pistol for Tanzillo. He's going to go have a conversation with Keyless on the wing on the left side. Now he'll go over to the other side and have a short conversation with Austin Fenske. Takes it, looking to pass. Has some time this time. Now under pressure, rolling out to the right, and he is going to be taken down outside the numbers. Initial contact out there made by Triggs, and it's going to be a loss of a couple of yards for Tanzillo and bring up a fourth down and 11 for the Bulldogs.
So this time Tanzillo was able to get to the side where he may be able to throw the football, but the pressure coming. There was four or five defenders there for Horlick to take him down and just not able to get anything going. 1 yard
loss on the play. Fourth down Central.
6:20 to play here in the first half. 26-0 the lead for Horlick.
You know, it doesn't really look like there's too much of a size difference between these two lines, but the speed for Horlick has shown so far.
The linebacker play has been a big difference. You've seen Fletcher and Brown get in there a lot. You know, that defensive line is just holding things up for those guys to really flow to the action. Going to go for it on fourth down here. Fletcher showing blitz. The handoff goes to Keyless. He slips out of a Fletcher tackle, but then Fletcher comes back, and him and Brown team up on Keyless, and Keyless taken down officially back at the 36-yard line, a loss of five, and a turnover on downs for this Rebels defense with 5:49 to play in the first half.
They went back to the same play they got a first down on previously on their first rushing first down, and that time the Horlick defense able to sniff it out. They got some disruption right away in the backfield, and the second effort just not able to get anything after that.
5:49 to play. Horlick, all but one of their drives has started in West Allis Central territory. Here in this game, they have scored
the Rebels from the Central 36
on all but one of their drives, and that ended in an interception. The handoff goes to the back coming out was Griffin, and Griffin is able to wind his way down to the 20-yard line. A pickup of 16 for Griffin and another first down for Horlick.
16-yard gain on the play, taken down by Bryce Sweaty.
Griffin with 36 yards on two carries. Horlick has only had two carries that have not gone for at least 10 yards. Fletcher with both of those, and they've been touchdown runs of 4 and 5 yards.
It's been a great night on the ground for this Horlick offense. They don't need to throw the football at all, especially the way that they're going so far tonight.
And we have an official timeout as there's going to be a player swap here. Not sure if it was due to an injury and they wanted to let him get off the field. And now we're going to be ready to go. 5.5 to play, 26-0. Horlick leads, and they're knocking on the door again at the 20-yard line of West Allis Central. Brown is in the backfield. He's to the right of Fletcher. Fletcher working out of the shotgun. Now he's going to check back over to the sideline. They check the wristbands, and they're ready to go. Fletcher sends Brown out. Empty backfield. Fletcher spins. He's going to run with it off left tackle. Nice little leap. Fletcher down to the 5. Fletcher diving forward just short of his third touchdown. Down to the 1 yard line. A pickup of 19 for Fletcher. His longest run of the game. And the 10th first down of the game for Horlick.
Fletcher wanted to get in on the rushing attack, and that time got it down to the 1 yard line, first and goal.
See if Fletcher keeps it himself here. So close. They're going to empty the backfield. He's checking the poker table wheel.
From the one.
Their little octagon. He's going to work out of the pistol. Takes the snap. He's going to go right up the gut, and he slips by the first defender, Rivera, and trots into the end zone. Fletcher, his third TD run of the game. This one a 1 yarder, and Horlick leading West Allis Central 32-0 with 4:31 to play in the first half.
This option offense for Horlick just continues to confuse the Central defense. They're not able to get good enough penetration to try and disrupt the snap, let alone the handoffs that Fletcher's providing, and that time he kept it, able to get by the defender and into the end zone.
They're going to go for two here. Fletcher under center. Behind him, he'll have Griffin.
Touchdown run, the Rebels will go for two.
Wings on each side. Gives to Cozy. Cozy isn't going to be able to get there. Great job by Austin Fenske. Got a little bit of the back of the jersey and then was able to hold him up and then catch up and get the hips.
It's one of the best stops so far tonight for this Central defense. And unfortunately, it comes on a two-point conversion attempt after the touchdown's already been scored.
That looked like me. I used to do some security in college, and we had a dance at Marquette, and there's this guy that bolted through the doors, and I was the door supervisor, and all I could do was grab his shirt, and I'm just holding on, and his shirt is ripping away from me as he's sitting there getting to the main stairs, and he starts climbing the stairs, and I'm starting to finally be able to catch up because he hits the stairs, and I'm like, all right, I got him, brought him down to the ground. But that's what that reminded me of, a flashback to my college days.
Remind me not to mess with you, D-Watt.
Nah, take it easy. I'm older and slower now. All right, we're going to step away for just a moment. It's Horlick 32 and West Allis Central 6.
Off for the Rebels.
Horlick waiting to kick off. Similek kicking off. And he's been putting it all over the place. And last week they had Fletcher kicking off. Similek will boot it deeper. And coming up and running up on it for West Allis Central is Ramos. And Ramos is going to be taken Sergio down as Ramos he gets towards the sideline. Ramos taken down up at the 31-yard line. And that's where West Allis Central will start with the football
taken
on this
down
drive.
By Jeremy Cozy. First down, Bulldogs!
West Allis starting field position. They're 35, they're 20, they're 19, they're 35, they're 28, and they're 31. That's about equal to where Horlick started.
Yeah.
Every drive is at their side of the field. So field position, a big thing in this game, and obviously it started off right away on the opening kickoff as Horlick squibbed it over to the right side, and they were able to recover, and then they went into the end zone just a few plays later. Only one drive has Horlick not gotten into the end zone. Actually, they got into the end zone. Then there was a penalty that took those six off, and then they threw an interception.
And then got the ball back right after that, the very next play.
Yep, and then very next play after that, Sprague's in for a touchdown. So 3:54 to go here in the first half. Tanzillo under center. He hands it off to Safidis, and right away, somebody from Horlick got down low. And for the Rebels, that was Lorenzo Pius that got underneath
the
offensive lineman, and Safidis picks up just a yard on his sixth carry.
2 yard gain on the play,
and they'll
second
say two,
down Central.
Equaling his biggest gain for the leading rusher for this Bulldogs team.
Yeah, tough going for Central's offense. The rushing game, they've tried to get something going on the interior side. They've had success on the outside. They had it on a fourth down play. They were able to get the outside, get a first down. But things just have not been working when they've been trying to rush the interior.
20 or 32 zip in favor of Horlick with 3 minutes to play in the first half. Safidis alone back in the backfield, and he may have gotten an early start there. Or will this go against Horlick? Were they offsides? They were offsides. They call that
Moriante
Shelton
against Horlick.
One of the few miscues by Horlick tonight, and it's been mostly penalties. They've had, I think, what now, three or four penalties
now? Fourth penalty now, yeah.
For the Dogs.
Fourth penalty for 25 yards for Horlick. And again, last week, the turnovers and the penalties were the Achilles heel. They had a turnover early on in this one. They were able to recover from that.
And it's going to be some coaching
second
moments after this game. Regardless of the score, the mistakes still have to come up a lot better for this team.
Safidis again, the lone back behind Tanzillo. They have a receiver set out to the right, only one wing on the right side. Hard count by Tanzillo. Tanzillo might have been looking for a flag, doesn't get one. Now the countdown starting. He's going to have to snap it. He does. He gives to Safidis, and Safidis again, absolutely nowhere to go. Fletcher getting off the pile along with
Safidis with the carry.
Moriante Shelton and Safidis. And we have a West Allis Central player down.
Luke Coney, the injured Bulldog.
It's going to bring up a third down and three here for West Allis Central with the injury. And Cody, you know, you don't know what you're going to get. You have these young teams, and Horlick came out and they had a little bit of a tough time against Park. They come here against West Allis Central. Both teams, again, just seven seniors on both squads. You have a lot of young players out here. You have a lot of players that maybe you were expecting to have for the 2020 season, the fall season, if you would have had it. But now, because it's being played in spring and there's added sports in spring, maybe some of those players chose not to do football and chose to do one of their other sports that maybe they prefer a little bit more. All sorts of things, wrenches in the plans of these coaches.
And it makes you wonder, too, how this spring season is going to affect their fall season as well. Some guys that maybe decide to go out for other sports and maybe come back for the fall, you know, what's their place going to be on the team? Or some of these younger guys going to have more opportunities next fall?
39.
And some coaches just viewing this as a bonus because there is no postseason for the spring football season. The handoff fakes it to Safidis, gives it to Keyless. Keyless tries to get outside, and he's able to pick up the first down. Gets up across the 40 to the 43-yard line. A pickup of five for the third first down of the game for West Allis Central. So Central, they're starting to move the ball a little bit at times, but then they have a miscue and sets them back, and they can't go backwards. They can't go behind the line of scrimmage, and they've been doing that way too much here tonight. Obviously, credit the Horlick defense for a big part of that.
Yeah, they've been great on the interior side of the defense. Fletcher in the linebacking core there have been great. And for Central, they've been able to find some room on the outside. It just hasn't been all that much.
A minute 25 left in the first half, 32-0, the Horlick lead. Looking to pass, Tanzillo fires one. It was tipped by Fletcher at midfield. It'll be incomplete. And it's going to bring up a second down and 10. And that's one where one of the few times Tanzillo has actually had time to stand back there, scan the field, find a receiver, and get that plant foot forward and plant it and get a good throw off.
Yeah, he delivered a good ball and just a little bit off the mark. And like you said, it got tipped. But two receivers going right down the middle of the field, both had an opportunity for it. But a good job by Horlick defenders, able to get a finger on it and disrupt that pass.
32-0, the Horlick lead. Here in the second quarter at West Allis Athletic Complex. Want to thank the athletic director here for West Allis Central, Justin Marion, for providing us some space and some interwebs to be able to bring this broadcast. Shotgun for Tanzillo. Quick pass to Keyless. A blocker in front of him on the screen. Keyless with the lane down the near sideline, the 40, and he'll go out of bounds at the Horlick 34-yard line. That will be a pickup of 23 yards as Keyless has receptions of 28 and 23 in the game. And now, for the first time, Central in Horlick territory at the Horlick 34.
We saw them with the screen pass to the outside earlier in the game. It went incomplete, and that's the first time we've seen it come back to it. Great success there and great speed there. Had good block on the outside to be able to find some room.
Bensky and Keyless out to the right. The H-back is Safidis. Tanzillo out of the pistol. Tanzillo looking to pass, looking to his right, under pressure, and is not going to get out of the grasp of initially Moriante Tanzillo Shelton for Horlick all the way back Moriante at the 43-yard line. It'll be a loss of 9 on the play, and West Central Allis will take Central. A timeout with under a minute to play here in the first half. Horlick leading 32-0, and it's going to be a second down and 19 for Central. And again, that's what we're talking about, getting behind the sticks. And there, Horlick had three free defenders coming in.
Yeah.
And there was just nowhere at all for Tanzillo to go.
Well, on just a few plays previously where Tanzillo was actually able to find time, I think we were both kind of shocked he was able to find the time and deliver a good ball this time. Like you said, the defenders got three, they got through, provided the pressure and got the sack, but Tanzillo just has not had a lot of time to drop back and pass. So for him to even try to deliver a good ball, it's almost impossible.
Yeah, that one, I mean, he didn't even have to move. It was a very rare opportunity where he got to scan the field and he saw a nice pass by him. If he has the time, but this Horlick defense is not giving him the time, and on the ground, they are just not giving up much. On this drive, they did give up a rushing first down, essentially three rushing plays that resulted in a first down, but that has been so rare here tonight from this Horlick defense.
Yes, it has. And for the Rebels, they've just been swarming around. They're leaving the defensive backs out there and just letting their linebackers do all the work.
Tanzillo will work with an H-back to his right, two receivers off to the left, Quillis out wide to the left, and Fenske in the slot. Had some time again, now rolls out to his right and steps up in the pocket and nowhere to go. And it's going to be a loss back to the 48-yard line as there are two or three different Rebel players. And they're going to give it to Chapman officially, a loss of four. And now you've gone backwards 9 and 4 yards on consecutive plays, taking sacks, and you end up having a third down and Racine basically to get a first down here.
Yeah, for Central, they had both of their receivers on the left side, and the Horlick defense was able to push him off to the right, not able to get a good clear view to the receivers, and Tanzillo just never had a chance.
For the Dogs from the Rebel 48.
15 seconds and counting to play here in the first half, so see if Central, if they can get Tanzillo some time to look downfield, if that's what they choose to do. Instead, they are going to hand it off to Fenske. Fenske finding a little bit of room in the middle of the field, but coming in, trailing the play from behind
Fenske
for Horlick was Anon Houston. And that will bring us to
the
end of the first half as Fenske unable to get anything going there. And at the half, 32-0, Horlick leads West Allis Central. We're going to leave you with no audio for halftime, just so you know, no audio for halftime. And we will have some still placards up there as well as a shot of the field. We know the camera is having a little bit of a hard time focusing on the scoreboard here at night, but 32-0 is the lead for Horlick over West Allis Central, and we'll be back in about 12-13 minutes, recap the first half and bring you the second half of play in this one as Horlick looks to go 2-0 on the season. They're well on their way here at halftime, leading the Bulldogs of West Allis Central 32-0. We'll be right back.
We're at the half at the West Allis Athletic Complex, and it's all Horlick as they lead the Central Bulldogs 32-0. And take a look at our stats from the first half of play. First, let's take a look at the scoring rundown quickly. 10:56 to play in the first quarter. Fletcher, a 4-yard run. The fetus kick was wide left. 6-0 Horlick. With 8:39 to play, Spragans took one in from 19 yards out. The pass was incomplete on the two-point conversion attempt. It was 12-0. 2:07 to play in the first quarter. Fletcher's second run, a 5-yarder. And the direct snap for the two-point conversion was good. It was 20-0. Then in the second quarter, 11:48 to play, Spragans a 21-yard TD run. The kick was blocked, 26-0. And then with 4:31 to play in the half, Fletcher, his third TD run of the game, a 1-yard run, and the run was no good for two-point conversion. 32-0 the lead for Horlick, and they are set to receive the second half kickoff. There was one turnover by the Rebels, an interception following a holding, negating a touchdown, the only drive they haven't scored on. So you have Fletcher as 1 of 2 for 18 yards in interception. His one completion was to his tight end, Tommy Trigg, for 18 yards. There have only been 3 plays, offensive plays, in this game for Horlick that went for less than 11 yards.
Wow.
And they were all the touchdown runs by Fletcher. 4, 5, and 1 yard, as they have amassed 214 yards rushing on just 13 carries.
Wow.
So you're looking at about 16 yards a carry for Horlick. Fletcher, 5 of 40. 5 for 106 and 2 TDs for Spragans. 2 for 36 in the game for Griffin, and he had a big one negated by a hold as well, or an illegal formation. And then 1 for 32 for Jordan Brown. Or actually, it was Brown that had the one negated by a legal formation. 10 first downs in the first half for Horlick as we're about ready to get underway with the second half of play. Meanwhile, for Central, they have run the ball 24 times for minus 31 yards. They are 3 of 7 passing for 53 yards. Horlick, they do have 4 penalties in the game, but for 25 yards, so something that carried over a little bit from last week. So Cody, 32-0. I was expecting Horlick would pull this one out. I don't know that I saw it by in this sort of fashion here tonight.
No, I would agree with that. I did not see this much of a margin coming, especially in the first half. I did see Horlick probably winning this game, but hopefully Central can make some good adjustments at halftime.
And it's going to be a little bit of a squib kick by Tanzillo, and it's going to be jumped on at the 33-yard line by Horlick, and getting on top of that ball was Spragans.
Spragans balls on the ball. For
so
the
it'll
Rebels.
Be Horlick football. Horlick. First and 10 at their own 34-yard line. And for Horlick, that is their second worst starting field position. That only the second time they have started on their side of the 50. In the game.
Yeah, it's been tough for this Central defense. Not only have they had a hard time in the rushing game, but also they've been set up in bad spots defensively with great field position for Horlick.
Don Wadowitz, Cody Ortner here at the West Allis Athletic Complex, bringing you the Horlick Rebels game courtesy of the Racine Raiders. Under center, Fletcher. Fletcher hands off to Spragans in a big hole. Spragans a 50, the 40, the 30. Spragans a blocker, and that might come back as a block in the back. We'll have to see. Spragans into the end zone, 66
yards.
No flag on the play, and Spragans 172 yards on 6 carries in the game. His third touchdown run, and Horlick leading 38-0 on the first play of the second half.
Great blocks on the outside with Spragans again using his speed and just outrunning everybody, and then got a great block downfield as well to just really bust his way loose.
Simulik on to try the point after for the Rebels.
I wasn't sure how the officials would see that when it looked like he got in front of them. And the block started legal and then maybe kind of went to the back, which is a legal block.
swinging gate again, but they are going to set it up for an extra point attempt by Similik with Aiden Graham holding. As Horlick tries to make it 39-zip. Snap is high. Graham grabs it. He's going to roll out to his right. He fires Brown with the catch, but he's knocked just short of the goal Aiden line for Graham's the two-point conversion. And the Bulldogs, the it was Tanzillo that was able to lay a lick on him and stop him just short. And it's 38-zip in favor of Horlick right off the bat here in the third quarter. Thanks for tuning into the broadcast here tonight. We'll keep it right here as the music seems to be at a little bit lower of a level, and we just brought you from a bunch of time at the half here with our placards. Hey, we'd love to hear what you think about the broadcast and the quality of it. One of the things we're looking at adding would be a scoreboard graphic on the stream so you know what the score at least is. And again, it's a two-man crew here tonight. So a lot of work to be done by Cody and myself. Cody manning the camera while providing commentary. I'm doing the production on the stream that's going out to all of you. And so a lot of work to pull one of these off. And sometimes your focus is in a couple of different places at once. But we'd love to hear in general what your thoughts are. Make sure you tweet that or send it out on Facebook or Instagram to the Racine Raiders. Similik's kick is a line drive kick that is going to be taken at the 20-yard line, handing it off at the 20 was Fenske.
Austin Fenske fields the kick and
the return to Ledesma up to the 34. It'll be a first and 10 for West Allis Central there. West Allis has started their drives at their 35, their 20, their 19, their 35, their 28, their 31, and now their 34-yard line with 11:47 to play and a running clock situation with Horlick up by 35 in the second half.
Yeah, it's been quite the difference for both of these teams with starting field position on each drives. Like you said, for West Allis Central, they've started in their own territory every single time. For Horlick, they've been in West, they've been in Central's territory half the time they've been on the offensive drive.
Tanzillo is going to go under center, but first he's going to talk to his mates in the backfield. The fullback is Angelo Rivera, and the halfback is Safidis, the deep back. Two receivers to the right. The handoff goes to Safidis, and Safidis able to fight his way forward across the 35-yard line to the 37-yard line as he picks up three, and it'll bring up a second down and seven.
The biggest thing for the Central offense, yeah, you're obviously down 38-0 on the scoreboard, but what can you take away from this ball game, not only as a coach, but as a player as well? Just trying to execute the small things, and the small things are what's going to make you successful down the road.
Second and seven for the Dogs from their own 37.
High formation backfield again behind Tanzillo. One receiver split out to the far right. That's Keyless. Tanzillo takes the snap, hands it off, and fighting a forward for a couple of yards will be Safidis. And looked like he was slow to get up, but he pops up now.
Safidis
up to the 41-yard line. He picks up four on the play, and Safidis's last four or last three carries have gone for 5, 3, and 4 yards after having nothing more than 2 yards in the first half for the most part.
Getting better and better, wearing down that defense as the game goes on, as you'd say, Don.
There you go, 9:20. They've been so busy in the middle. The Horlick defense was just so dominant early on, just amazingly dominant early on in this one, setting the pace. Rivera and Safidis again in the I formation backfield as Central looks to have something going with this. The handoff to Safidis, and he plows his way forward. He'll have enough for a first down up to the 45-yard line as he picks up 4 yards again. And you can get a few first downs that way if you can pick up 4 yards a carry.
And it looked like the offensive line, since so far on this drive, has been able to get some better pushes, open up some holes for the running backs. And there you go, a first down right here on the opening drive of the second half.
Both teams with one first down in the second half.
Yeah, there you go.
They're marking even on that front.
Of course, Horlick's was because of a 66-yard TD run by Spragans, all pretty much untouched. Going back to that two on each wing formation with Rivera in the backfield. Fakes the handoff to Rivera, gives to Keyless on the end around. The ball's knocked loose. Coming in and knocking it loose was Cozy, but it's going to be picked up by Cozy Central.
Keyless with the carry.
And able to hop on top of that one was Ramos. But it'll be a loss all the way back to the 39-yard line, a loss of six.
Well, that could have been disastrous for the Central offense.
Just Central.
Those small things where it can really just throw off your team, and especially a turnover. They've already had a few tonight, and just really now sets them back in a second and long.
Second and 16 coming up for
second and
Central.
16 for the Dogs from their own 39.
And again, we talked about that. You have progress for, you know, they're making progress, and then they have one of those that on first down puts them way behind the chains, and here we are again for Central. Rivera is the back in the backfield behind Tanzillo. Tanzillo takes, fakes the handoff, rolls out to his left, under pressure, steps up, finding time, firing across the field, and it's incomplete.
Is incomplete.
On the coverage for Horlick was Adrian Richmond. He was looking for Aponte Jr., and it'll bring up a third down and 16 for the Bulldogs.
Great job by Tanzillo to be able to shake off the defender, plant the foot, and deliver a pretty good ball. That was pretty catchable by the receiver Jr. there, just not able to haul it in. But a good effort nonetheless for the Central offense.
With the running clock, under 7 minutes to play in the third quarter, a 38-zip Horlick lead.
16 for the Dogs from their own 39.
Keyless split out wide to the left, back in that I formation backfield that they had been using successfully early on in this drive. Safidis the deep back, Rivera the fullback. The handoff, nope, fakes it to Safidis, looking to pass, going long for Keyless, and Keyless just gave up on that one.
Pass is incomplete, intended for JoJo Keyless.
Henderson on the coverage for Horlick, and it'll bring up a fourth down and 16 for Central. And Keyless, it looked like if he would have kept going, although Henderson had nice coverage and was on the inside, so Keyless would have had to have tried to find a way around him, and that might have been what he saw as being an impossible task.
But even at that point, if you try and make an effort to keep going towards the ball, you don't know. You could draw a penalty, a pass interference, something like that, whether or not the defender can get turned around to make a coverage play on the ball.
5:45 to play.
39.
Central will go for it here with the running clock already in play, with it 38-zip in favor of Horlick. Rivera the back behind Tanzillo. Tanzillo takes the snap, fakes the handoff, rolling to his left, under pressure again right away, steps up and nowhere to go. He's going to be taken down at the 40-yard line by Brown, and that will be a gain of a yard, but it's going to be a turnover on downs, and that's the second time in the game that they have turned it over on downs.
Yeah, try to go to the air again there, and Tanzillo, more pressure again. He's been running for his life all night long, and that time tried to do something but not able to, just had to get a yard. Turnover on downs. Horlick, once again, great field position to start the next drive.
Yeah, go figure. They're in the central side of the field once again with under 5 minutes to play in the third quarter with that running clock. Time clicks down quickly.
First and 10 for the Rebels.
Still with their starters in there. Griffin is the lone back in the backfield. Fletcher under center. They double handoff and they give it off to Hubbard. And Hubbard all the way down the near sideline into the end zone. Touchdown,
Reggie
Horlick.
Hubbard
with the
40-yard
TD run for Horlick. And they just cannot be stopped right now.
Oh,
but now we do have a flag down at the 16-yard line. And they're talking to Central. So it might be coming back.
It looks like it is.
Holding is the call against Horlick.
That's
so it'll be a spot foul. So where are they gonna say that happened down at the 12-yard line.
From the spot of the foul.
So you still give them a credit for a 28-yard.
It is still a first down for Horlick at the Central 27.
28-yard carry on that one. It'll be first and 10 from the 27. They still get the first down to go with that. Under 4 minutes to play in the third quarter. So take the six off the board, but still enough for the play. The handoff, it goes to Cozy, and Cozy finding some room outside, and he'll be ripped down at the 10-yard line.
Cozy,
a pickup of 17 on the play for Horlick. And another first down.
Gain of 17
for Horlick,
on the play. First down,
and
he'll
set
Horlick
up a first down and goal at the 10-yard line for the Rebels. As they're getting a lot of different players involved. Last week, not too many folks touching the ball.
Flag on the play.
There was a flag on the play. And after the play, unsportsmanlike conduct.
And that will go against Central. Their first penalty of the game.
Penalty is half the distance to the goal.
So it only amounts to a 5-yard penalty for Central.
First and 5 for the Rebels from the 5.
So Horlick with it at the Central 5-yard line. Fletcher checking over with the sideline. Right now, empty backfield other than himself. Three receivers split out wide to the right, one receiver to the left. Receiver to the left is Hubbard. Fletcher takes, spins around, hands it off to Hubbard. Hubbard trying to slip a tackle and can't quite get into the
Reggie
end zone. It'll be a pickup of 4 for Hubbard and bring up a second down and goal. And that's
goal
the first time in the game that Horlick's had a run of under 11 yards that didn't go for a touchdown.
Yeah, nonetheless, another great effort. Fletcher sold it on the high snap and then able to hand it off to Hubbard, and Hubbard was almost able to get into the end zone once again.
Griffin, the back in the backfield this time, as Fletcher checks the octagon for the play. Under 2 minutes to play here in the third quarter. Running clock, 38, zip Horlick, and they're on the doorstep again. Fletcher takes, gives to Cozy, and Cozy... Cozy could have cut inside, and he went right at the defender and plowed through him at the goal line and goes into the end zone from a yard out. And Cozy with his first TD run with 1:43 to play here in the third quarter. I'm looking at that through my binoculars, and I'm like, oh, he's got an easy walk-in. And then all of a sudden he just goes right for the defender like he's on special teams trying to lay a block or something and just plows right over him.
Must really love the contact because, yeah, he could have just sidestepped to the right. He's in the end zone easily, but no, he went for the contact and nonetheless
following
a touchdown.
1 yard touchdown run. Quinn Simulac
44 zip.
To drive the point after.
Hank Aaron to nothing is the score here at West Allis Athletic Complex.
Hopefully, kids,
Ernest
you
Biner,
understand
we
that.
We can make it football. Ernest Biner.
Yeah, there you go.
To nothing. Swinging gate again, and they'll come out of that and give Simulac a chance to put it through for the first time this game. Make it 45 zip. Last time the snap was way up, and it is again. Goes through Graham's hands. Simulac picks it up, but he's going to fall at the 15.
The snap,
so back-to-back high snaps. And it's 44 zip in
no
favor
good
of Horlick with
Horlick
1:43 left to play
zero
in the third quarter. Horlick in this one as they're on their way to 2-0 on the spring alternate season. We'll be back in a moment on this broadcast of Horlick Rebels football, brought to you by the Racine Raiders. Let's get that point. We're happy it's a running clock, Cody. My toes just cramped during the break.
Oh, come on now. This is football weather in April.
I'm ready for softball, man. Get me out there. I need to get throwing still. I haven't had a chance to get out. Maybe this weekend. It's supposed to be gorgeous. Similicon to kick off for Horlick. Nice little line drive kick that is going to go down inside the 20, be picked up by Griffin, and he brings it up and breaks a tackle at the 20, slips it outside, drops the football, but it looks like West Allis Central recovered.
Ledesma on the return, fumble on the play.
And Ledesma with the return, and Rivera with the recovery. It'll be a first and 10 for Central at the 29-yard line, their own.
That's the third time tonight we've seen Central put the ball on the ground and they're able to get back on top of it. Otherwise, this could be way worse of a score for West Allis Central.
And West Allis Central, you know, one of the things for Horlick is they have had head coach Brian Fletcher there for a long time.
Yeah.
And so that is something that helps him, whereas Coach Soom, it's his first year here at West Allis Central.
Tough first year to have to start in the spring also.
Yes. Coach Fletcher, a former Racine Raider himself. As Tanzillo sets up Rivera. Tanzillo, the snap. And he's going to take it forward, and Tanzillo across
Tanzillo
the 30
on the keeper.
To the 33-yard line. A pickup of four for Tanzillo.
4 yard gain on the play. Second
brings up
down,
second down
Central.
And six for Central. And we'll see if they even decide to run a play, and they're not going to. They're going to go to the sideline, and we'll step away. 44-0, Horlick leading West Allis Central here at West Allis Athletic Complex in the suburb of Milwaukee. We'll be back in a moment on this broadcast of Horlick Rebels
That's
football brought to you
quarter.
By the
What's
Racine Raiders.
Score?
Well, give some credit to first-year defensive coordinator Sam Bartlett with what he's done with this Horlick defense, leading 44-0 at the start of the fourth quarter over West Allis Central. Central falling last week to Brown Deer 30-9. Horlick, this defense allowing Park, and actually Park scored off of a defensive touchdown.
Yeah.
The Horlick defense has not been scored on yet this year. Now, hopefully that's not a broadcaster jinx for the Horlick fans out there. Direct snap, and the ball is loose again for the fourth time in the game. And there's a fight for it. It originally looked like Central got it, but then it came out again. Horlick's indicating that they have it.
And they do.
So a fumble by Tanzillo, and finally Horlick comes up with one, and coming out of the pile with it is Savion Chapman.
Isaiah Harris.
He was happy to get that football out of the pile. He came running out, went to the sideline, and yeah, I got the ball.
So you were just talking that they had put four on the ground in the game, and now, and they had three up until that point, and they hadn't lost one, and now they do. and deep in their own territory. Again, Horlick starting at the West Allis 31-yard line.
First and 10 for the Rebels from the Central 31.
Letcher, who split time at quarterback last season, the sole quarterback this year for Horlick. And we're going to have a timeout taken by West Allis Central. And
timeout Central.
For Horlick, maybe a touch early to be talking about this, Cody, but their last shutout came back on October 19th of 2018. You look this up in the first round of the WIA tournament, 42-0 over Shorewood Messmer.
Yeah, they actually had a shutout, I think, even earlier on in that season as well. I think they had two, maybe three shutouts that season. Let me take a look again, but yeah, 42-0 Shorewood Messmer in the first round of the playoffs, and then they also had a shutout earlier that year against Milwaukee Marshall to open up the season 31-0.
So a couple of this Horlick team has always had a really good defense. That's kind of been a bread and butter for the team, and then the offense can do enough to kind of help them have success. And under Coach Fletcher, they've been able to build that offense and to be able to do enough and be successful in a lot of ways. And we're seeing it again here tonight as they are just picking up chunks of yardage on the ground. Letcher rolling out to the right, looking to pass, throwing for the end zone. And what a diving catch down at the 1 yard line by Logan Ray. An absolutely gorgeous catch on a 31-yard pitch and catch.
It looked like that ball was going to sail out of bounds, but a great effort to snag it and get it down to the 1 yard line at a first and goal.
Just lofted it up there. Absolutely beautiful pass. And Ray getting underneath it and coming down with it. At the 1 yard line, first and goal, Fletcher looking to pass, trying to hit a receiver out of the backfield, and he does so. That is Hubbard,
complete to Reggie Hubbard
with the touchdown reception. But we have laundry on the field. Had a couple of receivers out over on the left side, and it's going to be a touchdown. So Fletcher, with three rushing TDs in the game, adds a passing TD on the 1 yard.
The touchdown stands.
Touchdown pass
Central
to Hubbard.
And you know, talking, like you said, he split time at quarterback last season. And now as a sophomore getting the full-time job, he's just going to continue to get better and better with more experience over the coming years.
Hubbard had two catches for 16 yards last week. 50-0. Horlick with the lead, going for the two-point conversion, and Brown loses the football. Never got a handle on it. And you know, Cody, that's a situation where here tonight, it is cold, and that ball is starting to get wet.
Yeah,
and the combination of the cold hands and the moisture that is in the air from being sub-freezing right now is wreaking a little bit of havoc for both these teams, as we've seen on the last couple of drives here.
Yeah, especially for Central. They put the ball on the ground, I think you said, four times already tonight, and they were able to get back on some of those, or at least most of those. The last one they weren't able to. Horlick able to take over right away and get down the field. We saw an incredible catch on that drive, and then a nice touchdown pass to finish things off, and just not able to finish it with a good two-point conversion.
So they put up 50. Have the Horlick Rebels 50-0 over West Allis Central. Horlick looking to pitch their first shutout since 2018 in the first round of the WIAA tournament. Thanks for tuning in to our broadcast of Horlick Rebels football, brought to you by the Racine Raiders. Don Wadowitz, Raiders broadcaster, and Cody Ortner here with you from West Allis Athletic Complex, standing on top of the West press box. That's the visitor press box, but interestingly enough, that's where they run their public address announcing out of and have their speakers on.
There you go. It's been a fun night tonight.
Similek on for the kickoff, and he's going to boot this one fairly deep, fielded at the 19-yard line by Safidis, and Safidis will bring it across the 30 up to the 32-yard line, and West Allis will start with it there. With 8.5 minutes to play in the game, and
brought down by Savion
the clock running with the running clock situation pretty much has been the entire second half as Horlick scored on their first touch of the second half, that 66-yard TD run by Spragans.
Yeah, it's been really tough for West Allis Central. They just haven't been able to get much going on offense. They've had some nice plays on third and fourth down to continue drives, but then they'll stall out with a big negative play.
First and 10.
Some confusion now as they send two receivers out to the right, one receiver to the left. Safidis in the backfield with Tanzillo. And now Safidis will go to the H-back spot, a little bit in front of Tanzillo and to his right. Tanzillo, snap is up and over his head, and he's just going to have to fall on it back at the 24-yard line. And Tanzillo, that's another thing where we have seen some issues here is on snaps. And it's been for Horlick on the extra point snap.
Nine on the play, second down.
But now we see it there out of the pistol formation. That West Allis Central has trouble with the snap. And again, cold, ball is cold, wet, moisture. It's, you can see your breath in the air. It's not a dry night out here, even though skies are clear and we've had no precipitation of any sort. But it's just that dewy wetness.
Yeah, and this time of season, you don't know what you're going to get weather-wise. Next week, it could be 70 degrees.
I think that's what they're saying.
Yeah.
That'll be wonderful. Would be much better up here if that was the case.
Absolutely.
We could be grilling out. Tanzillo under center. Hands it off. Safidis coming from the left side, trying to find some room. Cuts it up. He's going to be taken down by Elijah Barajas. And Safidis gets back to the 26-yard line. So a gain of two will bring up a third and 17 for West Allis Central.
As the running clock continues on, let's see what West Allis Central is able to put together on offense. They've been sticking to the ground game here in the second half despite the running clock. I kind of wouldn't mind to see them try and go to the air a little bit more just to try and see if they get some continuity going.
27.
6 minutes to play in the game. 50-0. Horlick trying to pitch their first shutout since 2018. Tanzillo, long snap count, trying to draw Horlick offsides, can't do so. Fakes a handoff, rolls out to his left, throws it up and a little bit too high. His pass
was
intended for Martinez, and it's going to bring up fourth down. And that's the third straight incompletion now for Tanzillo.
Yeah, he's been running for his life all night, and this time he actually had some time to throw. He might have felt the pressure coming even though it wasn't there, and the receiver is open. He just wasn't able to deliver a good ball.
5.5 to go with the running clock.
Fourth and 16.
West Allis Central with it at their 27-yard line. They need to get up to about the 43-yard line, a little beyond that, to pick up the first down. They've turned it over on downs a couple of times already in the game. Tanzillo takes out the mouth guard, puts it back in, and now a newer player in the game. For Central, he has to direct traffic, throwing it out of the flat. The catch is made by Safidis, and Safidis isn't going to get anywhere near enough to the 35-yard line, and it'll be a turnover on downs after the pickup of 8.
Gain of 9 on the play.
Yeah, they've had some success on the screen pass tonight where they're able to get a first down earlier in the half. But that time, able to get some positive yards, not able to get a first down. But for West Allis Central, you're able to get something even though you turned it over on downs.
And so Horlick at the West Allis 35, all but two of their drives have started in West Allis territory here tonight.
First and 10 for the Rebels from the Central 35.
Letcher. Under center, looking to pass, throwing middle of the field, hits his tight end, Triggs. Tommy Triggs breaks a tackle inside the 20, and he'll get down to the 15-yard line on the gain of 20 on the pass completion.
Triggs using his size that time and getting some space after the catch, able to break through some defenders and get some extra yardage all the way down to the 15-yard line.
Two catches for 38 yards for Triggs. Brown to the right of Fletcher. Fletcher rolling out to his right, looking to pass. Fletcher on the run, throwing, and it goes off the hands of his intended receiver and is nearly caught by the receiver behind that one. That was Aiden Graham. That was behind, I believe, Hubbard out there.
Intended for Logan Ray. Second
down. Check that. That was Ray. 3:15 to play.
We've been seeing Horlick running pretty much all game, and then the last two drives, they've gone to the air. Despite the running clock.
4 of 6 in the game for Fletcher. Yeah, he was 1 of 2 coming into this fourth quarter. And obviously, something Horlick wants to work on.
Yeah, exactly.
So they haven't had a chance. While the game was still a game, he didn't feel maybe comfortable going that route. And Fletcher rolling out to his right after the fake handoff, throwing to the 5-yard line again, trying for Triggs into the gut of Triggs, but he couldn't hold on to it. And it'll bring up a third down and 10 for Horlick with 2.5 minutes and counting with the running clock to play.
If he was able to read through a little bit more, Graham was wide open in the end zone on the right side. He was waving his hands, not able to find him, and had to throw across his body instead.
Third and 10 for the Rebels from the Central 15.
And looking to pass after the fake handoff, throwing it up in the end zone, and what a nice catch, and that is his tight end. Triggs making up for the last one.
Fletcher's pass the is 15-yard complete to Tommy Triggs for 15 yards.
Passing TD, and it's the second passing TD of the game, and the fifth TD total for Fletcher.
And yeah, talking about the cold again, Triggs had to let it go off his hands the first time and corral it back in, able to get that catch.
53 yards through the air for Triggs. Fletcher under pressure from the backside. Fenske brings him down on the two-point conversion with the sack, and with 1:40 left to play, Horlick leading 56-0 in this one with the running clock, and we might get a kickoff here, and that might end up being about it.
Nico Sefidis with the play. The conversion is no good. Your score,
so Fletcher, the 15-yard TD pass to Triggs.
Zero.
His second TD pass here in the fourth quarter. And Horlick with a huge lead. And you look at it today, and I think, you know, you go Spragans is probably offensively, just with the numbers he's put up, your player of the game offensively, six for 172. Fletcher obviously right there on his heels, 5 rushes for 40 yards, and he's now with 3 rushing TDs. He's now thrown for 2 TDs here in the second half, as he's gotten some decent yardage now too through the air. But and that offensive line, you know, the offensive line does not get credit, and no matter who has touched the ball, they have not been touched for 10 yards at a time.
Similar kickoff for the Rebels.
So similar cool kickoff with just 30 seconds left to play in the game. Again, a running clock with Horlick up 56-0. And the ball is going to be mishandled and then picked up by Ledesma, and Ledesma nowhere to go. He'll be taken down at the 15-yard line, and that
Ledesma
will
with the return
be all for this game, as the clock will run out before they can get the offense out there. The Horlick Rebels on their debut on our Racine Raiders YouTube channel. A big showing for Horlick here, Cody. 56-0 over West Allis Central. Horlick improves to 2-0 on the season, and their first shutout since a 42-0 win over Sherwood Messmer back on October 19th of 2018.
Well, Don, I'd like to say we had a part in that. You know, now that we're here, we got to come back next week. And, you know, the shutouts will continue the rest of the season.
Well, and this defense has not been scored on. The one score was a defensive score by Park. And next week, Horlick is scheduled to play Case at Horlick Field. Now, we're not sure that that game will happen at Horlick Field. There is a light stand at Horlick Field that needs repair work. The city has been waiting on the state to approve the repair work that needs to be done on that. They have not gotten that approval as of earlier today. They're hoping that comes, they can repair it, and we can have football at Horlick Field next week with Horlick taking on Case, because it would be awful to have to send a Horlick Park game to Kenosha and then send a Horlick Case game to Kenosha when we have two beautiful brand new fields sitting in Racine that are turfed and just wanting to see some action, Cody.
Yeah, hopefully they're able to get that figured out. And like you say, you'd hate to see them have to play somewhere else at a great field like Horlick. And so yeah, hopefully it's able to get done, and it'll be a great game regardless. Two teams that know each other very well.
I want to thank you for coming out in this weather and joining me. Appreciate it, Cody.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you guys for tuning in as Horlick takes down West Allis Central 56-0 here tonight on our inaugural broadcast on the Racine Raiders YouTube channel. If the game is played at Horlick Field next week, we will have it for you again on the YouTube channel. Look for the link. We'll be sending that out as we know more information. But thank you to Cordy Ortner for joining me. Thank you for tuning in. Horlick improves to 2-0. West Allis Central falls to 0-2. I'm Don Wadowitz reminding you to live life to the fullest and be good to one another. Have a great night, a wonderful weekend, and a fabulous Easter if you celebrate. Thanks for tuning in. Good night.